Magical by the Sea, some kind of, I don't know, magic show. Are we looking for Paul Daniels?
Yes.
Or Penn and Teller by the Sea, doing a magic show, and we're looking for Puff, the magic dragon who lives nearby.
All right. Hey, by the way, you got this great question in the live chat here. I'm going to queue it up. It's been scrolling down as we're chatting, but I want to go back up to it. This is excellent, if I can find it. Yes. Do you think that dragons could be allegoric of lizard men?
No. You're finding the really craziest questions, aren't you? You're loving this. It's excellent. It's great fun.
You don't like lizard
men? No, I'm not. To be brutally honest with you, I'm not into lizard men. I had one round for a cup of tea the other day.
Are you a lizard man bigot?
He ate the china. Do you know what I mean? It's not good, and you run out of biscuits very quickly, and you have to have a sandbox in the corner. So, no, I'm not into lizard men, so consequently, no.
Okay. All right, and let's see, we have this question here. Have you ever seen vertical rainbows around the UK?
Do you know I haven't? That sounds absolutely fascinating. Can you ask the guy who's put that one on to kind of say a little bit more about vertical rainbows?
All right, well...
it sounds really interesting. Yeah. You see, the thing is, I will say, we're on Skype here between us, which is the only way we can chat. Yeah. And unfortunately, my computer's kind of archaic. It's run on kind of mouse power. And they're kind of running around in little wheels there, which means the only program I can actually run is Skype. Mm-hmm. Which means I can't actually go onto the web and have a look and see what's going on there. It'd be really fascinating to see what's kind of being talked about.
All right, yeah, that was Tim from Hawaii. So, Tim, you if you're still watching, you'd like to clarify or even drop Steve an email. He has they can contact you on your website, can't they, Steve?
They can, yes. Steve at dragonsandrings.com. If you go to dragonsandrings.com, there's there's all kinds of things you can do there. There's going to be more.
Yeah.
We're working on it. We're building.
Okay.
Articles, forums, whatever.
Okay.
So, yes, you can contact us on
there. Alrighty. Now, how close are you, and have you visited Stonehenge?
Now, you see, from you guys in America, if I were to say, it's a good 120, 140, 150 mile journey, you'd think, oh, that's next door. Mm-hmm. It's the opposite end of the country, I guess, from me. But yes, I have been to Stonehenge, and to be brutally honest with you, I'm not terribly impressed by Stonehenge. Mm-hmm. It's actually quite small when you get there, and it's a pile of stones stood on end, and to me, It didn't do much for me. There's a place not far away from there called Avebury, which is absolutely spectacular compared to that. It's literally a stone circle with a village inside it. That's how big it is. Plus, it's got kind of avenues of stones and pyramids and burial mounds and all kinds of stuff. Yeah. It's absolutely brilliant. Excellent. Stonehenge doesn't do a lot.
Mm-hmm. In your video, I saw some of those circles. And it seemed like people had small farms in those circles. Is that how big they are?
That's the one. That was Avebury that you were looking at. That was over the top in a helicopter, which was brilliant stuff.
Yeah,
that's how big that stone circle is. It's a village. It's not just a farm. There's a village in there, a whole village, a church, pub, various houses, crossroads, if you imagine. It's quite a big village.
Yeah.
So that gives you an idea, I guess, how wide it is going to be. It's huge.
Mm-hmm. All right.
It's not something you can kind of put on your desktop and kind of have as a little kind of toy for during the day when you want to play with a few stones or something.
All right. And for those who just tuned in, we are talking with Steve Mitchell from the UK, and we're talking about Dragons and Rings. He has a video, which you can go to his website there and take a look at that. Steve, we have a question in the live chat. Is there a place called Avebury Rings, A-V-E Bury Rings?
Right, this is exactly what I was talking about, Avebury Stone Circle. I believe that's what he's referring to. It's a village, like say, in Wiltshire. Again, just go on to Google search Avebury. There's some video on site where you can just see Avebury from above on the Dragons and Rings website, the main video on the main page. You'll be able to actually look at that. If you want to kind of click on there now, you can see what it looks like and see literally how big it is from the air.
Well, the interest in whether or not dragons did exist, and it's a fair topic because that is half the name of your video, but this writer wants to know if, in fact, dragons did exist, do you think in any way they could destroy the Earth, say, like maybe they could re-arise? You know, wasn't there a movie called Ring of Fire? Have you seen that?
It's not Ring of Bright Water you're thinking about, is it? That has an otter in it, not a dragon, though. Ring of Fire. Yeah. I can't think of a movie called Ring of Fire.
Well, you've got to rent it. It's based basically in, I think it's in the UK, and
right.
they were digging in a tunnel in London, and they hit a lair of a dragon who escaped up and repopulated Earth with dragons and burned the entire world down, except for a few brave humans who tried to fight the dragons.
Well, I guess if you will go disturbing them, you know, they're probably busy asleep. Imagine being woken up yourself.
I'm not
going down the dragon kind of theory stuff. It's, to me, like I say, it's an energy. It's an energy source. It's to do with the energy that's around us, and it's to do with the energy that effectively makes us who we are and keeps us alive.
Could be Puff the Energy Dragon. Steve, hey, listen, we have got to go to break, so just stay with us on the line. All right.
Okay.
All right, everybody. On our Newsmaker line, of course, is Steve Mitchell from the jolly old country of England, and we're talking about his new video. And I don't know how new it is, but I've got it right here, Dragons and Rings. Go to his website and find out about it. And if you have a question for Steve, go to the edgeam.com website, click on the Fast Blast, or join him in a live chat going on now. We're going to be right back. This is The Edge Television Broadcasts.
You're listening to The Edge Radio Program, a show so hot, your radio might catch on fire.
Welcome back to The Edge Television Broadcast. My name is Daniel Ott. On our Newsmaker line tonight is, of course, Steve Mitchell. We're talking about crop circles. How about dragons, rings? What do you say? Do you have a ring? Wait a minute. Wasn't there a show called The Ring? Rings can be a fearful thing. And a lot of talk about Johnny Cash. Wait a minute.
I was toting my pack along the dusty Winnemucca road when along came a semi with a high-end canvas
covered load. Everybody sing with me now.
If you're going to Winnemucca Mac,
if you're wearing black out there.
And so I climbed into the
cab. You got a question for a guest tonight, go to the broadcast link.
Seen a road with so much dust and sand, and I said, listen, I've traveled every road in this here land.
Hey, don't forget this exciting interview will be posted tomorrow on the Edge's website, and you can get involved many ways. You can join the forum, sign up for the newsletter, become a correspondent. So many ways you can be part of the Edge staff. And by the way, we want to welcome Yvonne Cat to Larry's Spiritual Channel, Spiritually Speaking program coming up very soon. And as you saw, once again, Prophet Tom Deckert will be in Indianapolis Friday, June 6th at 7 p.m. and Saturday at 10, 2, and 7 at the Wingate Hotel, located 2 miles north of the airport, I-465 and Rockville Road. So it'd be worth a trip. If you don't even live in Indianapolis, you need to go there because, I'll tell you what, go to the Edge's website and search his name, Tom Deckert. We had a great time, and perhaps we'll get him back on the program, too, as well. Now let's go back to our newsmaker line. See, we have back with us Steve.